This is Kumiko, and a single panel costs $2,700. And in the words of a fellow Canadian, but what if I could just 3D print it? For the past 3 months, I've been designing, prototyping, and endlessly printing to make my very own. But there's a problem. You see, Kumiko is a traditional Japanese woodworking technique that takes small pieces of wood to create panels with beautiful patterns of art. These panels tend to get quite large, much larger than the print space available in an average 3D printer. So I first needed to make the project scalable. My printer is limited to a 25 by 25 centimeter build area, so I needed to figure out how I could take small components and put them together to make a fully scalable triangular grid. I started with simple hexagons, and while they do pattern well for this situation, there's not a lot of area available to create strong connections between them. So I took advantage of the large area available at the center of the hexagon to create dovetail joints, which now let me pattern the shape horizontally. This even lets me create pieces with a thickness as small as 2 millimeters while retaining a bit of strength. The last adjustment I made was making the pattern symmetrical when rotated 180 degrees, and finally maximizing the pattern for the print bed. By doing this, I also solved the problem of how I was going to connect the patterns vertically. Since the dovetails take up the central joints, I could use the frame to join the rows together. There are other ways of connecting pieces vertically, but this was the approach I went for in the end. When putting the frames together, there was one thing that was really nagging me the whole time. Something I really didn't like looking at. And that was the seams. So I worked towards getting the project seamless-ish. The challenge with seams lies in balancing effort with quality. While doing nothing requires no effort, the seams remain obvious. Conversely, a seamless result requires considerable work, including filling, sanding, and painting the model. Fortunately, there's a middle ground where we could reduce the appearance of seams with a minimal amount of effort, and that involves editing the model. So I went into Fusion 360, and for every joint in the frame, I created recessed sections which allow me to create an insert to cover the seam between the two frames. When put together with the final border piece, which contains hidden dovetails, I think this does a good job in reducing the number of seams while creating a more unified frame. The beauty in Kumiko comes not from the frames, but the inserts that go inside. So the final step in this project is to customize. On the Wikipedia page for Kumiko, it notes that there are nearly 200 Kumiko patterns used today. For this project, I modeled and printed 38 different patterns, but today I'll only be using 3 patterns and 3 colors. In total, I printed 251 blue pieces, 236 red, and 541 beige for a total of 1,028 inserts. The only thing left now is to put it all together. The first step was to assemble the frame. The inner portion of the frame is made up of 48 panels tiled together. Of all the components used to create this frame, the panels took the longest to print and used the most material. It took 80 hours and 2,300 grams of filament to create these panels. Then to complete the inner frame and connect things vertically, I printed 32 inner border pieces, which took 9 hours and 250 grams of filament. To cover the seams, I used 124 copper plates, which only took a few hours to print and about 100 grams of filament. To frame the outer edge, 32 border pieces were printed using 180 grams of filament and 6 hours of printing. Finally, for the inserts, each insert required a background piece, which if using a translucent filament can be used as a way to backlight the panel. For this panel, I wanted the inserts to stand out from the background, so I used matte black filament. In total, I needed 1,650 background pieces, which used 500 grams and 20 hours to print. Finally, the 1,028 inserts required 75 hours and 1,800 grams of filament. Overall, after 196 hours of printing and 5,150 grams of filament costing about $100, I had my very own Kumiko panel. Now, if you want to make your own miniature panel like the ones shown here, these were all created using a model that I made available on MakerWorld. This model lets you customize a panel however you'd like. You can adjust the inserts, change the color of the panel, and of course, modify the dimensions based on the number of triangles or the exact millimeter dimensions that you need. Once you've modified the panel to your liking, you can print the components individually, which will let you swap out pieces in the future, or print your panel as a single component, which I would recommend for panels with small pieces. The link for the model is available in the description, so you can make your very own miniature panel today. The possibilities with this simple yet beautiful design are really endless. I want you to take a moment to think about how you could integrate Kumiko into your life, as an artwork, part of a lamp, or something else completely. Like and subscribe, and thanks for watching.